Hello and good day. In this video, I have included several ideas from the others that I have done on the same topic, but I have arranged them in a different order. I trust that this time I can explain more concepts better and in less time. I hope that when you hear or read the words voltage, current, coulomb, ampere, and others, it will appear in your mind a clear and tangible image of what each of one means. The behavior of water in a gravitational field is strikingly similar to that of electrons in an electric field. This is the key to seeing, understanding, and discovering why, when you move electrons, you get wonderful things. I should start by talking a little bit about these three fields that we're not able to see, yet we know about them. Water is attracted to the center of the Earth because of the gravitational field. If on its way, there were no materials obstructing its path, we must assume that gravity would make the water reach the very center of the Earth. Air is a good conductor of water, but solids stop it. They are insulators. No one has seen the gravitational field, but no one doubts of its effects. The magnetic field, among other things, attracts metals made of iron. I think we have all had the experience of feeling the magnetic field by bringing a nail closer to a magnet. Like water, air is a good conductor of nails, and solids are good insulators. No one has seen the magnetic field, but no one doubts of its effects. The gravitational and magnetic fields attract things that capture our senses, such as water or nails. But what attracts the electric field are electrons, objects so small that it is their effects that make us have an idea how they move. We have to believe without seeing. It is enigmatic. Now, I require your imagination to see with your eyes closed. I also need your goodwill to accept things that are not real, but that help enormously to understand what cannot be seen. Physicists say that an electrically neutral atom has as many electrons, negative charge, as protons, positive charge, and I believe them. Imagine that with your hand, you separate an electron from an atom. You need to invest a lot of work because they're very attached. As soon as you pull it apart, the atom is positively charged. This is how I imagine an electric field is formed. The further you move it away, the more work is needed, as with a rubber band or a slingshot. If you release it, the attraction will return it to the hole it came from, or to any other atom that it's on its way back with a missing electron. These are the fountains that serve to drink water. This is a fountain that is used to operate a hydraulic apparatus. It consists of two containers. The one below that I will call a cistern, and the other one, 1.5 meters above, that I will call a tank. I'm going to fill the cistern with billions of water molecules. Now, I'm going to load the tank, transporting the water from the cistern. The tank is loaded. It is filled with water that is drawn to the cistern by the gravitational field. The only way to go down is through this conductor, a tube through which water can pass easily. This is a transducer. When water passes through it, its axis turns. It can be called a hydraulic motor. This is a switch. I operate it, and a stream of water from the tank to the cistern is established, and the shaft turns. This is a fountain that has variable height. For a stream to be established, there must be a certain vertical distance between the tank and the cistern. I'm going to call it heightage. The engine manufacturer establishes a heightage of operation. Let's say between 5 and 10 meters. At less heightage, it does not spin. More heightage can break it down because so much water would pass through it that the intensity of the current would destroy the motor. This is a battery that is used to operate an electrical appliance. It consists of two containers, the one below that I will call positive, and the one above that I will call negative. In my house, I don't have what it takes to make a battery. But let's imagine that the manufacturer made it with the following recipe. The bottom container, the positive, is filled with a substance that has billions of atoms from which it is very easy to remove an electron.
In an incredible way, it separates an electron from each atom.
rises it to a height edge of 1.5 volts, and releases it in the negative container. When filling it, billions of electrons remain above and billions of positively charged atoms below, because they lack an electron. The manufacturer joins the two parts and sells it to us under the name of 1.5 volt alkaline battery. By moving electrons away from their atoms, an electric field is formed. But the imaginary process followed by the battery's manufacturer made it in such a way that the only way for the electrons to return to neutralize the atoms is by using a conductor outside of the battery. Metal is a terrible conductor of water, but it is an excellent conductor of electrons. Air is a good conductor of water, but a very poor conductor of electrons. This is a transducer. It is a device that rotates this axis when electrons pass through it. It is called an electric motor. This is a switch. These are conductors, copper wires for electrons to pass to neutralize atoms. If I close the switch, it will establish a current of electrons due to the electric field, which, similar to the current of water, will rotate the shaft and the fan will push the air, creating a pleasant wind. I imagine that the smallest thing that can be called water is a molecule. I asked Google how many molecules are in a liter of water, and it answered all of these. 3.35 times 10 to the 25th power. It is not practical to measure the amount of water in a container in water molecules, but it is very easy to measure it in liters, cubic centimeters, grams, ounces, gallons, cubic inches, etc. We have many units to choose from. For example, this fully charged tank is about 5 liters. Current. When water passes from one place to another, a current is said to be formed. The intensity of the water current is a number that expresses how much water passes through a place in a given time. For example, 100 cubic meters passed through the water tube that enters the school last month. About 300 gallons pass through the river every day. 20 liters of water come out through the shower every minute. 10 cubic centimeters are passing through this conductor every second. There are thousands of ways to express the intensity of the current of water that passes through a place. It is measured in units of volume between units of time. Just as it is not practical to measure the amount of water in molecules, it is not practical to measure the amount of electric charge in electrons. So physicists have agreed to use the single unit worldwide, the coulomb. I asked Google how many electrons are there in one coulomb, and it replied that approximately 6.24 times 10 to the 18th power. Imagine a container with all these little red balls. How many coulombs are there in a battery that you can buy in any supermarket? Depending on the size is the number of electrons that can be separate from their atoms. These are images of some well-known batteries. For example, the D-type battery. The largest of the so-called alkaline is sold with a charge of 46,800 coulombs. The C battery has 21,600. The AA has 8,640. And the smallest, the AAA, with 3,600 coulombs, eager to go neutralize atoms in the lower side, the positive. These are approximate numbers. The actual capacity of each size depends on the manufacturer, the model, and other things, but they give a good idea of what each one can store. Current. When electrons transit inside one conductor from one place to another, a current is formed. Its intensity is a number that expresses how many of them pass through a place in a given time. It is measured in a coulomb per each second. The unit of charge is always the coulomb, and second is always the time unit. It is never expressed in coulombs per hour or per month. It is always measured in coulombs per second. The drawing shows the electrical circuit connections, a battery connected to a motor. When a current passes through the wires, the shaft rotates and the blades move the air. The apparatus is a voltmeter.
It shows the height-edge at which the electrons were separated from their atoms. Remember?
1.5 volts. It is connected between the negative and the positive sides of the battery. It is said to be in a parallel because the two terminals of the meter are connected to those of the battery, where you want to measure the voltage. A voltmeter behaves as an insulator. The electrons from the battery do not enter in it. This device is called a multimeter because it can measure voltage and current. I changed the way to connect it to show the current in coulombs per second. It is said to have been connected in series because all the electrons passing through the motor pass through the current meter. A current meter is an excellent conductor. The current is 37.7 millicoulombs every second. That is 0.0377 coulombs per second. If I connect two batteries, one on top of the other, when the circuit is closed and the current flows, the electrons on the negative side of the battery will look for atoms in the battery above to neutralize them. And the electrons in the top battery will neutralize the atoms in the bottom battery.
The difference is that now, between the motor terminals, there will be a heightage of 3 volts. I connect the multimeter as a current meter, and it shows an intensity of 72 millicoulombs every second.
At 1.5 volts, 37 passed. At the same time, almost twice as many electrons pass, making the axis rotate faster. What if we connect three batteries in series? The voltage rises to 4.5 volts, and the current to 0.111 coulombs per second. And so you can increase the voltage so that the electrons pass faster until the motor burns. The manufacturer specifies the voltage to which an appliance must be connected to work as expected. For example, when this fan is connected to 12 volts, it will pass a current of 0.16 coulombs every second. I think that now you can see that the current intensity is measured by counting the electrons that pass through a place every second. When they invented the coulomb, they made our lives easier by being able to use a simpler number. Well, physicists made up a word to say coulomb per second. They invented the ampere. When a coulomb is passing through a place every second, it is said that an ampere is passing. I think this is a reason why it is so difficult to understand the concept of current intensity. A coulomb every second is very well understood. A lot of electrons that are going through a place every second. But the image of an ampere is a little bit blurred in the mind. It seems that one day there was a goal to remove from the vocabulary the most elementary measure of electricity, the coulomb. Sadly, the capacity of the batteries is not commercially published in coulombs. The ampere hour is used.
An ampere is one coulomb every second.
1 hour is 3,600 seconds. Seconds are simplified. So 1 ampere hour is 3,600 coulombs. Just as it is not used to express the current in coulombs per second, it is also not used to express in coulombs the number of electrons stored in a battery. The voltage of a battery and the slingshot. Just as a rubber band or a slingshot cannot be stretched as far as we want, the electrons cannot be raised at any voltage. For example, in rechargeable batteries, the electrons can go up to 1.2 volts. In alkaline ones, up to 1.5. Those of cars, up to 2.1 volts. Thus, depending on the chemical substance used, it will be the voltage at which the electrons can be stored. To achieve higher voltages, the batteries are connected in series, one on top of the other, and each is called a cell. Such is the case of the 9-volt alkaline. It is not a battery where electrons were separated from their atoms, but 6 in series of 1.5. Those of the cars have 6 cells of 2.1. Short circuit current. It is when there is a passage of electrons, but there is no transducer. By mistake, a good conductor was connected instead of the transducer. In this case, an electron stampede occurs to neutralize the atoms. Billions of electrons pass almost instantly. It is usually so severe that the battery can explode if the conductor doesn't melt first. Where did the coulomb come from? Rising the electron to a certain voltage takes work. Due to the need to measure it, the coulomb was invented. One coulomb is that exact number of electrons that, when raised to 1 volt, it is doing a 1 joule work. Roughly all of these. The magic of an electrical system. In an electrical system, there is on one hand a battery charged with electrons eager to neutralize atoms. On the other are the conductors and the transducer. Magic happens when the circuit is closed and the current of electrons is transformed into amazing things, like making an axis rotate, the cell phone working, emitting light, producing heat, cold, and 1,000 other things. That is right, magic happens when electrons move. Thank you very much for having seen and heard this video.